Hey guys, welcome to the first video for SpatialOS with Unreal 4. In this video series, we're going to be converting the survival game project that I made a few years ago and make it compatible with SpatialOS. And this project is open sourced on GitHub. So SpatialOS basically is an online platform that lets you scale potentially to thousands of players in a single server as it shares the load over multiple servers behind the scenes without us having to really worry about it too much. And luckily for us, it works mostly with the same replication and networking code that we already are familiar with if you've ever made something multiplayer ready for Unreal. On top of that, it also provides the hosting for us. They will do the scaling and the server hosting, and we just need to provide the code and the setup to make it all run on SpatialOS. Okay, so what do we need to get started with SpatialOS? Luckily, they have some pretty sweet documentation available, and it should be fairly easy to get started. So we need to clone the Unreal Engine fork repository that's available on GitHub. Make sure you have joined the Epic Games organization on GitHub, otherwise you will not be able to clone this repository. And then we can simply use this URL or browse to the repository in your web browser. I'll put a link to both in the description as well. I'm using the GitHub desktop client, which is pretty easy to use. You might also want to use Git for Windows if you prefer to use the command line, for example. And then in GitHub, you go to File Clone Repository, click the URL, and here you'll paste in the URL and make sure you use a good folder. In my case, it's complaining because I already have cloned this before. With that said, you press Clone, and it will take a while to download the source code and make sure after it's done its initial fetching that with your Unreal Engine repository selected, you select the release branch for whatever Unreal version you want to build for. So in this case, that is 4.22 SpatialOS Unreal GDK release. So the release part is important here as well. And when you select the branch, make sure it's fetched so you have all the latest changes. And then you should browse to the Unreal Engine clone that you just created. Then we're going to run the install gdk.bat file. You don't need to run the setup.bat as you would normally would when forking because the Unreal GDK has already taken care of that for you. So double click, let it run. This might take a few minutes for it to complete. And it will also generate the Visual Studio project files for us. It will grab the Unreal GDK plugin and it will grab some sample projects that we're going to be using right now. Now, before we continue, we should install the SpatialOS client, which you can find in the Get the Dependencies. Again, link will be in the description. That will download it. You'll run the installer. Just keep clicking Next and Agree. And once that's set, you're all done with that. And then the final thing we'll do is set up the Linux cross-compilation toolchain. Now, we'll need this because the servers we're going to be building are going to be running Linux. So again, on the same page, we'll go to the cross-compilation for Linux, which will take us to the Unreal Engine docs. And here we can very easily find the toolchain that we need. Since we're running 4.22 in this video, we're going to be downloading that installer. And so with the toolchain downloaded, we're simply going to install or run the installer, and we're gonna keep the regular folder. Okay, with that done, we can close that. And with it all set up, we can go to Samples, Unreal GDK Example Project, and then the Game folder, and there we have the gdkshooter.sln, which we will open. And we can use this to compile the engine along with this little sample project to see if our setup has succeeded. All right, with it loaded, make sure your GDK Shooter is the startup project. And then it is set to Win64 and Development Editor as a configuration. That should be by default. And then we're going to just build the project, which will also build the engine. This can take probably more than 20 minutes or so, really depending on your machine. And once that's done, we can launch it using F5, or you can, of course, press the little arrow. And that will load up the SpatialOS sample project. Again, this might, on the first launch, this might take a while it's compiling the shaders. Don't worry, it's probably gonna be stuck at like 45% or so. And then once that is done, we have the project going. Awesome, okay. Now the final thing to do is to run a local deployment. We're not going to be using the cloud just yet. We're going to save that for the survival game. And for that, we need two things. We need a schema and a snapshot, which are two concepts from SpatialOS. And you can see these few extra buttons right here in the editor, which come with the Unreal fork for Spatial. So first of all, we can create this schema that will basically generate files for us that will be used by the server to understand what is replicated, which variables are replicated, and what to store and how to store it. So we're going to click that. That will generate a schema. We will go deeper into schemas and snapshots as we get further with the survival project. Okay, once that's done, we're just going to create the snapshot key, which is a snapshot for us, which is basically instant. And now we can play. So for that, we're just going to make sure that everything is set. Run a dedicated server, of course, because, you know, Spatial will always run on a dedicated server. We're going to set the number to 2, and we're going to launch into new 2 editor windows. That will start a local deployment. So the differences with the local deployment and the cloud deployment is that for the local deployment, we don't need to use the SpatialOS remote servers or build it for Linux and all that stuff. We can just locally run it on our machine for very quick iterations. So now we have verified that we have our local deployment working. And finally, with the game running, we can go back into the editor and click the inspector, and we can click here on these little nodes and zoom all the way in to see actually these entities in the world. So here we have the shield pickup, another one. And once we have converted the survival game, we will go into this with more detail and actually see things change here as we play the game and maybe make some changes to the game world around us. So I think that will be really cool, and it's generally a very, very useful tool in debugging and seeing what kind of data is on the server and which server worker is holding what data and where the players are and all those sort of things. Now with that, we have all the basics done to start converting our project. We have verified that it works with the local deployment, and then once we have a survival game converted, we can actually try it on the cloud, and then eventually maybe we get to add some of the simulated players as well. Please make sure to check out the description. I'll put all the required links for the setup at the top, so you can very easily follow along. And stay tuned for the next video where we're going to actually start converting the survival game project. I think that will be very cool. So stick around, and I'll see you in the next video.